Hi, good morning, friends. I am Dr. Dian Pansare, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Degree College, Aurangabad. Today we discuss on the IR spectroscopy, that is infrared spectroscopy. This is very important part in the organic chemistry. Main application of IR spectroscopy is to detection of the number of functional group. Before that, let's we study the electromagnetic spectrum. This is the electromagnetic spectrum, and these are the different types of ranges of the different types of rays, like cosmic rays, gamma rays, X-ray, ultraviolet, and infrared. On the right side here, microwave rays, ultraviolet, radio waves, like that. But we focus here only infrared, that is IR. The range of this is 0.4 to 1000 microns, that is wavelength. Here, this range is sunlight below 0.7 to 1000 infrared. Here, near IR, medium IR, and far IR. Now, this is the region of different types of IR, that is the near IR or overtone region is wavelength and wave number. Near IR wavelength is 0.8, 2.5 to 12,500 to 4,000. Here mid IR, vibrational and rotational region. Here wavelength is 2.5 to 50 and wave number is 4,000 to 200. Far IR rotational region. Here wavelength is 50 to 1,000 and wave number is 200 to 10. Mostly we have used the wavelength is 2.5 to 25 and wave number is 400 to 4,000. Now we can see the principles of IR spectroscopy. The principle of IR spectroscopy is when IR light is passed through a sample of the organic compound, some of the frequencies are absorbed while others are transmitted. Plot of the absorbance or transmitted versus wave number gives an IR spectrum. But conventionally, wave numbers versus transmittance is plotted because of the number of the more manageable. This is the IR spectra of the acetone or benzoic acid. Okay, the IR spectrum of the benzoic acid is shown below. First, you can observe here the wave number. At the bottom of the spectra, the wave number is given in the per centimeter, here 100 to 4000. Basically, the IR spectra, the peak is downward side direction are shown here. In the benzoic acid, there are one functional groups like acid functional group, and in acid, there are two subtypes again. One is ketone group and one is OH group is present. In IR spectroscopy, what happened? We detect or easily analyze different types of functional group like acid, aldehyde, alcohol, ester, carbon-carbon, double bond, triple bond, like that. Here in the red color, we have shown there carbonyl group. It is near about 1700. And OH group frequency shown near about 3000 per centimeter. Means we must know that the basic value of IR. If we know the IR ranges, then we can easily identify which functional group is present in the given sample. Okay, all carbonyl compounds shows IR range is 1700 to 1750 and OH group is shows near about 3,200. The requirement of the IR absorption or IR radiation absorption is correct wavelength of the radiation. If molecule absorb radiation only when natural frequency of vibrations of some part of the molecule is the same as frequency of the incident radiations. Requirement of IR radiation absorb, that is two electric dipoles. Electric dipoles are shown in polar molecules. Here, SCl is a polar molecule. We can see here, hydrogen shows partially positive charge, chlorine shows partial negative charge, and in between two molecules, that is intermolecular interactions also present here. If frequency of the vibration of HCl molecules exactly match with that coming from the source, net transfer of energy takes place. Changes in the amplitude of the molecular vibration absorb of the radiation. In case of the O2, N2 and Cl2, no net changes in the dipole moment occurs. Thus, they cannot absorb IR radiation and do not show IR spectra. Two types changes occur in the molecules. Molecular radiation rotations. What is mean by molecular rotations? Molecular rotations means that rotational transitions are of the little use to the spectroscopist. Molecular vibrations. The position of the atom in the molecules are not fixed. They are subject to the number of the different vibrations. Types of molecular vibrations. Stretching. One is stretching. Change in the interatomic distance. We can see in these figures. This is symmetric. Here carbon atom, for example, these are two, hydrogen is attached. Then what happened? These are the stretching. One time these two are stretched and one time is symmetric and asymmetric. One is long, one is short. That is asymmetric stretching or stretching vibration. That is change in the interatomic distance along the bond axis. Types of molecular vibration. There are four types of molecular vibration, that is bending, change in the angle between two bonds. There are four types of bends. One is rocking, scissoring, wagging, and twisting. You can observe here in this diagram, this is the in-plane rocking. These two bonds here, arrow is shows in this direction, left to right, means both two types. These are two types. That is rocking here, simultaneously this or this, that is the rocking. Here, in plane scissoring, scissoring means like this scissoring, close, open, that type will be bending observation. Here, these two are in plane vibration, these two are out of the plane, that is the wagging. One is near, one is far, or both are near, both are far, or one is near, one far. Like this vibration is present. Carbon dioxide can vibrate in the following ways. You can see here carbon dioxide, carbon double bond. Here both are contraction, both are relaxation. That is symmetric stretch. These are asymmetric stretch. One is here stretch, one is left side, one is right side. These types also stretch here. One is below, one is above. That is the bending vibrations. Below is the infrared spectrum of the ethanol with some identified fingerprint regions. Here, ethanol diagram or ethanol molecule spectrum. You can see here on the below side, 500 to 4000 per centimeter range. This peak shows OH bond is present. This peak near about 2900, that is CH bonds. Here shows near about 1100, that is the carbon oxygen bond. Okay, these are the different types of functional group ranges are shown in this diagram. Also here, carbon oxygen hydrogen bending near about 1500 to 1200 per centimeter are shown. Here carbon oxygen stretching also 1200 to 1000 per centimeter stretching are present. Vibrational frequency. A molecular vibration occurs when atoms in a molecule are in the periodic motion. While the molecule as a whole has constant translational and rotational motions, the frequency of the periodic motions is known as the vibrational frequencies. Now we can see the factors affecting the vibrational frequency. Which factors are affected particularly in this vibrational frequency, we will see in the step by step. Vibrational coupling, hydrogen bonding, electronic effect, field effect, nature of the solvent, we'll discuss later. Potential energy diagram or the oscillator. You can see here oscillator, for example here, two atoms is present here in between a radius or distance between two atoms. Okay, that is the stretching. On the y-axis energy, x-axis is on internuclear separation. Now we can see here this vibrational levels. V denoted as vibrational levels is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, like stretching. That is okay. That is the Morse on harmonic oscillations, or harmonic oscillations is there. Here dE and d0, that is the distance. Simple harmonic motion is a type of the periodic motions when the restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement. Unharmonicity is the deviated of the system from the being a harmonic oscillator in oscillation that is not oscillating in the simple harmonic motions. Solid film or solid film spectra. Solid film can be deposited into the NaCl plate by the allowing a solution in a volatile solvent to evaporate drop by drop on the surface of the flat. Polymers and the various waxy or fatty materials often give excellent spectra in this way. Vibration modes. Overtone, multiples of the given frequency result from the excitation from the ground state to the higher energy state. Overtone occur when a vibrational mode is excited from V0 to V2, which is called the first overtone, or V0 to V3, the second overtone. We can see here, 0 greater than 1, that is fundamental, 0 greater than 2, first overtone, 0 greater than 3, second overtone, 0 greater than 4, third overtone, and here, fourth overtone, like that. That is the sources. Inert solid heated electrically to lamp of the 1500 to 2000 Kelvin. Nernst blower, you can observe here, that is the consist of the cylinder of the rare earth oxides form into the cylinder of the diameter 1 to 2 mm, length approximately 20 mm, platinum. These are attached at the end of the cylinder to permit electrical connections. They are heated to a temperature of 1200 to 2200 Kelvin, where IR radiation are emitted. Nernst blower. Rare earth metal have large negative temperature coefficient of the electrical resistance. A negative temperature coefficient, that is NTC, occurs when a physical property such as thermal conductivity or electrical resistivity of the material lower with the increasing temperature, typically in a defined temperature range. Temperature is inversely related to the resistance. At low temperature, they provide high resistance to flow current, and as the cylinder gets heated, resistance gets reduced, allowing the conductance of the current. If large amount of the current flows through the cylinder, it can destroy the source. To avoid this source, circuit should be designed to limit the current. The blower source, similar to the Nernst blower, it is also made up of cylinder. Material used in the silicon carbides, you can see here. Length of the cylinder is the 50 mm and diameter is 5 mm. It has a positive temperature coefficient of the electrical resistance. At low temperature, they provide low resistance to flow current, and as the cylinder gets heated, resistance increase, allowing the conductance or conduction of the current. To avoid the excess heating, water cooling is the necessary. At high temperature, source emits IR radiations. This is also the incandescent wire source, that is the nichrome wire. You can see here, it is also source of the light, mercury, here quartz jacket tube, that is the Fg mercury vapors. Electricity passed through the Fg vapors provide the radiation. Again, tungsten filaments used in near IR, carbon dioxide, that is laser source, detection of the pollutant in the air. Wavelength of the selectors output from wavelength selector is a band of the wavelength. Filter, monochromator, entrance slit, collimating lens or mirror, dispersion element, prism or the grating, focusing lens or the mirror, exit slit. Difference between the monochromator and the filters. These are the monochromators, these are the filter. Means of the selection, wavelength, width, cost, probability. Here diffraction, absorption like this. If wavelength width is narrow, then we use filter wide. If the cost of the monochromat is expensive, filter is cheap. Probability, monochromator null, here VD. Capable of the recording spectra, yes, here no. Suitable for the quantitative analysis in the monochromatic, yes, and in filter also, yes. Thank you very much. Student, I think you should get the idea about the IR spectroscopy. In the IR spectroscopy, main application is to detection of the functional group of the different types of compound. When in the laboratory, we have synthesized different types of compound like organic or inorganic compound, we can easily identify different types of functional groups. But before that, we must know that the IR value of the different types of group, like alcohol amine. Amine value is near about 3200. Carbon-carbon triple bond value is near about 2250. Okay. And acid or alcohol is present, then its peak will be appear greater than 3400, like that. Or if halide group is present, the halide group value is near about 600 to 800. If aromatic compound is present in our compound, then the value of carbon-carbon double bond is near about 1600 to 1600. This is the IR spectra. Okay, thank you very much. I think you get the idea about IR spectroscopy. What is the IR spectroscopy? Then you get definitely for the study in your BSc and MSc. Okay, thank you very much.